He reaches Maidan and sits down on a bench. In the meantime, a drizzle starts, which shortly turns into a heavy rain. The early November night is quite chilly, and Hari's face and clothes become wet. He goes back to the bazaar and sits down in the shelter of the clock tower. When the clock displays the midnight hour, he feels that the damp notes hidden in his pajama string. Now he reaches a ground over there, and he sits on a table that was being laid there. And ultimately, when he was sitting over there, the small drizzle, it turned out into the heavy rain. It means bunda barishi jadi ho barish de vich badal gayi. Now, as it was November, so it was quite very cold, and Hari's face and clothes, they also became wet. Now he has to go back to the bazaar, and he went over there in the bazaar and he sat under the shelter of the clock tower. Now when the clock was displaying the time, now it was midnight hour, it means it was near about 12 o'clock. Now when he just paid attention, he was able to find it out that whatever the notes he had hidden in his pajama string, they were also wet. Hari's conscience begins to prick him. He thinks that he not stolen the money, Anil would have perhaps given him 2 or 3 rupees in the morning to go to the cinema. Now Hari's conscience begins to prick him. Matlab odi andarli atma si jehdi ohne onu chijodna shuru karta. He thinks that he had not stolen the money. Means now he started thinking that if he would not have stolen this money, then ultimately Anil would have given him 2 or 3 rupees in the morning, and he would have said him that you now go to the cinema and watch any movie. Although he now has all the money, he would no longer be able to learn to write. Education could have made him a great, clever and respected man, whereas stealing would not lead him anywhere. He decides to go back to Anil and learn reading and writing. Now what came in his mind, that as I am having all the money, but now I am not be able to learn or write because only money is there. Now he came to know what is the importance of education. Now he find it out that education is going to make me a great, clever and a respected man, and stealing, it is not going to give me anything. So he decided back that he is going to go back to Anil and he is going to start learning and reading over. He hurries back nervously to the room and finds Anil still fast asleep. He cautiously slips the bundle of notes under his mattress and goes off to sleep. Next morning, he gets up late and finds that Anil has already made tea. He comes to Hari Singh with 50 rupee note in his outstretched hand. He gives it to him, saying that he had made some money the previous day. He also assures to pay him the wages regularly. Hari feels happy and takes the note, which he notices was still wet from the night's rain. Now this boy, Hari Singh, he runs back fast to the room and find that Anil was still sleeping. So he just kept the notes back under the mattress, and he shows that he was also sleeping. Ultimately, in the next morning, Anil, he got up and he had already made the tea. Hari Singh was still sleeping. When Hari Singh stood up, then this man Anil, he gave him 50 rupee note, and he told him out that I have earned some of the money, so I am going to give you, and I am also going to pay you the regular wages, whatever work you are doing at my house. Now when this boy Hari Singh, he took that note, he was very happy, and he find it out that that note was still wet because he has stolen earlier night, and due to that in the rain it got wet. Anil tells Hari that he would begin writing sentences. Hari understands that his master is aware about the theft of the previous night but chooses to ignore. Now Anil tells Hari that now we are going to start with the sentence writing. And Hari, he also understands that my master is knowing that I have stolen the money yesterday night, but he is not saying me anything. A reformed Hari smiles in his usual way, but the time the smile is effortless and spontaneous. There is no deceit in it. Now the person Hari Singh, he had been reformed. He has changed. Now he stopped stealing anything. But now this smile, it was effortless and spontaneous. Means there was no effort in this. And it was a fast kind of smile. There is no deceit in it. Now there is no deceit in it means he was not a person who would be having such kind of the smile that I am going to cheat you. Matlab ki hai ki odi smile de vich koi aisi dhokhe wali gal nahi si. Now he was a changed person. So this is all. Thank you everyone. Hope you understood the story.